Welcome back to our series on the proposed Korean-U.S. Free Trade Agreement. We've been going over a list of 12 points that detail how this pact could destroy the American economy. Last time, we revealed the ways in which the agreement will essentially allow Korea to take over American banking and manufacturing, leaving the U.S. helpless to stop them. Let's proceed down our list. Number 6. American textiles will be put further in harm's way. South Korean textiles will overwhelm and eliminate American producers, further destroying states like North and South Carolina. Textile producers in the U.S. will again be handcuffed to compete with the low wages and labor standards of those in South Korea. Number 7. The U.S. beef industry will continue to diminish. The beef industry will suffer as Korea would be able to limit our inspection of Korean beef imports, despite constant refusal by Korea to import U.S. beef. Number 8. More contaminated food will legally enter the U.S., and we won't be able to stop it. Korea would be able to challenge our regulatory agencies, including being able to limit our ability to regulate the quality of food imports. Currently, less than 2% of imported food is inspected as it enters the U.S. This agreement will put limits on our ability to check food imports, restricting our already deathly low inspection abilities. We will totally lose our ability to protect ourselves from contaminated or toxic food. Number 9. Buy American food support will become illegal. Buy local food initiatives are important to economic development in the U.S., but implementing those initiatives could be compromised because they would be considered a non-tariff barrier to trade. Number 10. South Korea will still use trade barriers that the U.S. does not. South Korea has a value-added tax of 10%, which will act as a tariff after we give them duty-free access to our markets. They will be able to give tax breaks and subsidies to their companies, but we will not be allowed to do the same. This will be a huge barrier to American companies. We'll leave off there. Join us again next time as we finish off our list of reasons this trade agreement must not be allowed to pass.